Hello everyone, and welcome back to White One Racing. Today we have a nice surprise for you. The new Vespa Lodge Shaft, made by Sip Scooter Shop. So, today we'll still continue with the Vespa Lodge Shaft, since we wanted to show you this new Sip Shaft, which is very, very nice, and add some considerations that last time we didn't have to make about the proper coupling between intake phasing and thermal group phasing. As soon as we find enough shafts for the small, something I have, but I left to check, probably something is missing. We will also make a video about those because we've been asked, and we try to accommodate you if you let us know your requests. Here we are. In the meantime, I present to you the new shaft. Look at the profile of the shoulder. Very, very fluxed. It is hollowed in an intermediate way between Pinasco and BGM, even if the face is narrow. The face is practically identical to the original shaft. There is 1 millimeter of difference when measuring the open part, so it's about right. It has full knobs, seemingly full actually, because it's balanced at 12 o'clock and hollowed out inside. Hollowed here in the flywheel side part on this side, and then instead of the triangular hole that the original shaft has, the knob's intake side has an internal recess. The handwheel side of the knob is similar to that of the Quattrini. This shaft looks a lot like the Quattrini shaft. It is inspired by that, but it enters the crankcase, so it is not necessary to bring the crankcase to 99 mm as Quattrini requires. But it's mounted like this. This is the version we connect in rod 110 in stroke 60. Although the knobs on this shaft have a round shape, it leaves in the crankcase a vacuum quite similar to that left by the original shaft, because it's hollowed out inside. Of course, it creates less turbulence, so it is a little better in everything, and lends itself to be mounted in various ways and making engines in various sources, because now this is the one in stroke 60, but mounted as it is, it has a tight face and lends itself very well to work with an original cylinder, preferably the aluminium version, which was mounted on the thing for export to Germany, but also with a Pinasco cylinder, for example, in 60 stroke, wanting an extremely clean engine, giving up to a part of the power. Or you can progressively delay until you reach over 70 degrees, 75, which is that of the cut, actually almost 80, of the Mazzucchelli shaft. Clearly, if it's delayed, care must be taken to remove material from the knob. It can be done in various ways. On the one hand, try not to disturb the round shape too much, and therefore it can be done inside, or even by removing it, depending on how much material is removed here, even by removing a slice, which could mean improving the lubrication of the bearing on the flywheel side, on the flywheel side a little, which remains closed. The original shaft has these openings, and so much so that there is also a closed line on the crankcase, a trace of oil conveyance that ends in the hole. This cleaver-cut half-shaft thus favors the circulation of the air-petrol oil mixture. So much so that Quattrini, for their 244, prefers 4% blends. Now, this is something we believe, but I think it's reasonable to just something we believe, but it's reasonable to consider it. It's not certain why a cylinder like a thermal unit like the Quattrini one needs 1.5% of oil in the fuel. Perhaps because this closed knob, which also has the Quattrini, affects the lubrication and the bearing on the flywheel side a little. Now, let's try to get back to the topic. This video is dedicated, apart from the presentation of the shaft, just to this. That is, we have talked about all the times about the exhaust muffler phase coupling, saying that the muffler prevails, so with one exhaust, a rather high exhaust timing, you can still obtain its wheel performance, a generous torque already from medium speed, using the suitable muffler, perhaps under 190 degrees, yes, and we have also done some tests in this sense. When you exaggerate, you exaggerate. But it's certainly true. Now, this is an aspect of the question. A well-made and balanced engine necessarily sees the reconciliation of many, perhaps innumerable, parameters. Now, let's try to make a discourse that examines shaft timing at the same time. Exhaust and transfer facing, and therefore the muffler, even if I'll be brief about the muffler, and I only mentioned it because we have already talked about it. Now, this shaft, or a shaft with this phase, now it's not necessary to talk about this shaft, any shaft with a phase around 160 degrees lends itself to a thermal unit with relatively narrow phases. So, in the case of thermal group for, say, original, it makes little sense to significantly touch the thermal unit alone. Yes, you get something, but it's very little, because the intake delay has a huge effect on the engine efficiency, especially in the first 10-12 millimeters that are removed. That is, those just completely change everything and transform an original engine into one that pushes much more, while at the same time constituting a great compromise, because the regurgitation is never there. Beyond the limit, so if you remove about 20 millimeters, 22, what it takes to get to the Mazzucchelli phase, you try to squeeze high performance by giving up something like in terms of fluidity of delivery. Therefore, on the contrary, it makes no sense, and it is absolutely counterproductive, to go and look for a long intake phase, associating it with a cylinder with low exhaust and transfer phases, because it will mortify the smoothness of delivery at low revs, and will not be able to give anything to the highs, because the engine will not be able to turn, as the transfer and especially the exhaust will not allow it. Therefore, the intake phase can be between 160 and 190 degrees, or a little more overall, variously distributed between advance and delay. Now, on the Vespa Large, in order to increase the advance, except for the separate case constituted by the Quattrini shaft, which is a different thing, it's more advanced than the others because it's slightly different shape. The possibility of advancing is linked to the processing of the valve, because on the shaft it cannot be done because there is the crank button. Now, however, in general, apart from the fact that the valve shape gets dirty, it is better not to overdo the advance, because otherwise the phase will become too long even without reaching a great delay. And instead, for the purpose of performance, the delay gives greater results, even if the advance allows to keep the supply a little cleaner. However, today I also wanted to give you some small practical examples just on how to do it. Let's take the Malossi Sport, for example, which is a great cylinder. If we take it into consideration in long stroke, like 59 or 60, we can have a transfer phase that oscillates between 120, 122, 123 degrees, depending on the crankcase. Also on whether it is in the 59 or 60 stroke, and the transfer phase from 180 degrees up to 182, no further if you don't touch the exhaust at the top. At the bottom, it must be modified, because otherwise the step remains. At the top, we leave it as it is to maintain the character of that thermal unit, which such thermal unit with a truly remarkable performance, it is advantageous to settle on a less marked delay than the limit represented by the Mazzucchelli cut. So on the Mazzucchelli band, there are 19.5 centimeters. That is the closed part, just over 19 centimeters, 19.3.4. If you leave about 20, you get an extremely powerful engine that does not suffer the problem of regurgitation. So, if you want it even smoother, you can reduce it by another 5 millimeters, then leave a little more than 20.5 centimeters of closed band. Below this value, the maximum performance drops considerably, even if the engine remains rounder. Clearly, all the considerations made the other time about the volume of the crankcase and the relationship between the weight of the shaft performance, volume of the crankcase and inclination to the emphasis of efficiency. At the bottom, if the volume is less, up if the volume is higher. Phase the ratio to the volume of the casing, as by lengthening the phase, so I'm forced to increase the volume of the crankcase to balance. If you like this video, leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Remember, White Pond Racing is not a workshop, but an amateur sport association that works on engines only for sport purposes and only for its associates.